Hello, welcome back to another episode of Critical Reactions with your host, Brian. We're doing something interesting today. If you watched my last one on Panopticon, then you already know what's going on. But today's special selection, we're getting a double showing. Luis Zanoni has requested 3 songs in total. I figure we can give him the whole weekend. And that was 2 today, Panopticon and Sufjan Stevens, which is going to be this video. Tomorrow we'll be checking out Godspeed You, Black Emperor. But, you know, that's a big epic song for tomorrow. Today we're going to be checking out Sufjan Stevens, Tanya Harding. Now, I'm kind of expecting some sort of meme song here. The only other song that comes to mind when I hear this is there was this punk group that made a song about a hockey player, I think. I tried to look this up to prepare for this comment, and I couldn't figure out what it was based on my obscure, vague description there. But it was a comedic song about a hockey player, I think. And that's kind of what I think I'm in here. Like, Sufjan Stevens? I don't know. I'm not... That doesn't sound like a serious name to me. That's completely subjective thing right there. But I don't know. I'm not getting serious vibes off of that. And then a song about a famous person. I don't know. I have not had good luck with songs about famous people not being comedic. So that's what I think I'm in for right here. But Sufjan, let's see what's going on.
Here comes Tanya Harding. She now, Tanya Harding, with a chance to win a trip to Germany. And there's such a tremendous difference. If you finish third, you skate in Munich. If you finish fourth, you stay at home and watch on television. She was second after the original program 20 years ago.
Life's a cold one. Just some Portland ice skating. Trash. You confronted your sorrow like there was no tomorrow, while the rest of the world only left. Triple axle on high. A delightful disaster. You jump farther. I've said before that doing these reactions, I'm missing some context. That is certainly so here. I don't know anything about Tonya Harding other than the fact she's an ice skater. And I'm gonna confess, I kind of learned that right now. So this, I guess, was maybe her biggest performance as far as the video goes. 1991, I was 3 years old. Tonya Harding was kind of before my time, I suppose. Not that I've paid attention to ice skating anyways, but you know, there's always those athletes like Michael Phelps that even if you don't pay attention to their sport, they just became such names that you hear about them somehow. Like they make their way into your life. They kind of force it in. Tonya Harding is a familiar name. I have heard it before. I can't say I've ever known well who that was. Like I said at the beginning, I knew she was famous. It was a name I am familiar with. I just didn't know why she was famous or when. So yeah, I am completely missing that context here. The song seems to be some sort of pep talk for Tonya Harding. Says the world can be cold, the world can be mean, but you keep getting up and doing your thing, and you know, keep doing that, keep being awesome. And does she need this? Did she need this? I mean, I'm going to assume that the record label posted this since the channel is Asthmatic Kitty Records, and it has a buy link to it. So I assume that's Sufjan's record label, and this was posted December of 2017. So assuming that that's somewhere close to the date the song was made, we're talking a song that's way after her ice skating career, I would assume. So maybe she's been in the public light for another reason. I don't, like I said, I'm just missing the context here. It is a typical electronica pop ballad song. There's not much going on. I will say though, the dude's voice is beautiful. There's a nice warmth to it despite not being in the lower register. We're not talking about a baritone here, but there is some warmth that you typically only hear in lower registers. And there seems to be genuine concern and or passion for these words. I said coming in, I was expecting a meme song, some sort of comedy song played for laughs, and this seems to be very sincere. There are maybe a couple jokes at times, some of them a bit more on the nose. The world can be cold. She's an ice skater. But I think there's a couple other things in here where it's just comedic use of language, not necessarily punching down at Tonya or anything that she's done. Like I said, it seems to be very, you know, earnest and genuine about their concern for her and her well-being. So I don't. Like I said, I'm really missing that context, but I like his voice. I think there's some warmth and empathy and passion and compassion in his singing style. I'd like to see something else that maybe I can understand what's happening lyrically, because at least this song, my only introduction, my only experience with Sufjan Stevens is that it's poppy, where the music is more for a soundstage for the vocalist to perform over. Like most pop and electronica is, the music's not super complex. It definitely does not steal the spotlight in any way, shape, or form. It is mostly there to provide something for the singer to sing over, because otherwise you have spoken poetry, and that's a conversation for another time. Is spoken poetry music? So yeah, as far as this goes, I think that's about all I can say. I do like the vocal harmony oohs and ahs going on near the end. I think it was a chorus, and there was like these oohs and ahs that are three or four layered. three or four voices layered going on behind the primary singing. They were very nice, beautiful. There's a nice elegance to it. And I think it was also his vocals. So it gave, you know, it still had that warmth that I really enjoyed about his singing. But other than that, I don't know what else I can say. I think this might be my shortest video yet, just because this is a song I experienced, and that's the best analysis I got for it. I do look forward to checking out more Sufjin, though. Like I said, his singing is... I enjoy his singing. This song just doesn't make sense to me. Like I said, that's because the music is nothing to really talk about. It's more there to be hidden and provide a stage to sing over, and the lyrics are lost on me 100%. So this is where you guys come in. If you want to educate me on this song, I'm 100% down for that. I don't know why it was specifically chosen and why not another Sufjin. Lewis, if you're commenting, please let me know. Sufjin is probably one of the higher, I'd say top 20, maybe top 30 out of the 700 in the spreadsheet. Sufjin is definitely top 30 as far as requests go. Lots of people have asked me to check him out, and this is not making me understand why it's such a requested person slash band. So yeah. Like I said, though, this is where you guys come in. Help me out in the comments with any information. I'll be back tomorrow at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 10 p.m. UTC, with Lewis's final special selection, Godspeed You, Black Emperor. I think it's like an 18 or 20 minute epic, so it gets its own day, just like the last time we checked out Godspeed. And then we'll be back on Monday for unusual genre mashups, again at 5 p.m. Eastern, 10 p.m. UTC. All right, until then, you guys stay safe out there, keep being awesome, and have a fantastic morning, afternoon, or evening whenever you choose to watch my videos.